Hi everybody, it's been a minute. I was taking a live break and it turned into like a month long break of lives. So today I have a headache. I've had a headache for like a couple days now, and I think it's just a tension headache. I need to get a massage, so I have somebody coming over tomorrow, my neighbor, actually, to come and give me a massage to fix my neck, because I think it's just my neck is all busted up and it's causing this bad headache of mine. Oh my gosh, I pressed the wrong thing on my phone. Hang on a second. That's how long it's been. Okay, here we go. So I don't want to miss your comments and things. Yay. Hi Joe. Hi Margie. So I'm doing hi Noemi. I'm doing a fresh corned beef and cabbage. I actually cooked this in the pressure cooker for two rounds of 30 minutes. And it's a 3-pound corned beef. And I'm going to flip it over. I didn't want to put too much water in it because I always put too much water in it. But I put this in here with the brine that it came in, and I put just a little bit of water. I know headaches do suck. Hi, Chie. So there's, can you see inside? Kinda. I want to make sure you guys can see inside. So it's a 3-pound corned beef that I put the brine in, and I put a little bit of water. I didn't want to put too much water. But I can pick it up with, look at this. I can pull it apart with tongs. So I did one round, 30 minutes, flipped it over 30 minutes, and this is where I'm at right now. So it's very soft, soft enough for me to cut into. And I don't want to cook it for another round because then it'll be like overly tender and it'll turn into like Kahlua corned beef. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it out. I'm going to scoop it out actually. And then I'm going to put the onions and cabbage into the soup, and I'm going to cook that in there so it picks up all that flavor. And I'm just going to do that for maybe 10 to 15 minutes. So I have one head of cabbage and one whole onion that I just kind of sliced up. I'm going to put this in the pressure cooker. And I'm going to cook this separately. So while this is cooking, and I'm going to add a little bit of water in here. Just a little bit. I'd say maybe a cup of water. Enough to build steam and pressure to cook it. And then I'm gonna put salt and pepper afterwards if it's necessary, because I have the brine that was in here and I don't want to make it too salty. So I just put one onion and a head of cabbage in here, and I'm gonna put this in here for 12 minutes at full power, and then
hola,
we're gonna cut this up. And then we're gonna cut this up.
Thanks, Mom.
So hopefully you guys all were able to catch the episode. Hi, Paula. Hi, Sonia.
Ma, you didn't take a live for a long time.
I know, I didn't go live for a long time. Look at this. It's so tender that I don't want to saw.
Chop something?
I don't want to saw. I'm just gonna chop downward.
Guys, when I seen Mom on TV, I was crying inside mommy's room. Because I was so proud of her.
You were so proud of me?
Yep.
I was on TV?
Yep.
Wow. Did you tell Miss Kawakami? You forgot? Oh, you had resource day. Wow. So the corned beef. So on the package, I took pictures of the package. And it said that if you were boiling it on a stove, you would have to boil it for at least 3 hours. This was literally 60 minutes in the microwave pressure cooker, and this was a 3-pound corned beef. Ramel, can you try the corned beef? Ramel. Hi, Brenda. So I'm gonna hopefully go back. The reason I haven't been going live too is because I didn't really have a lot of ingredients in the house to like do anything exciting to cook. We didn't. What?
She wants to be live too.
Hi.
Can you say hi to everyone? Hi, can you blow a kiss?
Mom.
Wow. What are you eating? What is that? She's eating a Girl Scout cookie.
Hi, Johanna.
She's eating a Samoa. Eating a Samoa?
Say hi, Auntie. What's she wearing this?
Because it was cold earlier. We had to go to the doctor. I had to give blood. She was a good phlebotomist. Hi, I don't have any bruises on my arm. So she had to come with me to the doctor. Hi, Candy. Hi. Candy. Can you say Candy? Candy. That's her favorite word. Candy.
No, that's not how she says it.
How do you say it? Candy. You know what she says now? So awesome. Can you say awesome? So awesome. So awesome. Say awesome. And say awesome. She doesn't want to talk. She talks a lot earlier. Hi, Sherry. Hi, Bo.
She just wanted me to try it.
Yeah, how was it?
Good.
Like just good or delicious?
Wasn't it already pre-seasoned?
No, you just throw it in there with the brine and the seasoning packet.
Yeah, it's good.
So now what do I serve it in?
Hi, Brenda.
What do I serve it in?
In with the cooking cabbage?
Yeah. I'm looking for a container to serve it in that I can microwave. Something that's microwavable. I don't know what.
This is like eating cardboard.
What?
I don't know.
It's some healthy thing. I'll put it in here because this can go in the dishwasher. This is a crystal wave that I wish they'd sell more of these. This is a 3-quart crystal wave. Just okay? I know, right? Like, he doesn't even get excited. Hi, Jessica. Okay, so it's very, very tender. So if I were to pick this up, it might just shred. So I'm just going to put this in here because I'm going to cover this in the soup and the cabbage. But this was good. And I think this costed me $11. That's how much it was. So $11 for a 3-pound corned beef thingy. What do you call it? Corned beef. Raw, fresh corned beef. And then I'm going to throw the cabbage and onion with the soup on top of it after it's done. We have 7 more minutes. So what can we talk about? It's been a while since I've been on here. Is it still snowing where you guys are at? Because it's been pretty cool here. It was pretty warm earlier this afternoon. And now it's getting cool again with the sun starting to go down. Did you guys see the extra big moon? Or is that just in Hawaii? Like, could you guys see it? Ew, I don't know. Is it a slab? What would you call this? I don't know what to call it. I do need water. Hold on a second. I need water. So I did go to the doctor this morning, and I did gain a little bit of weight, but I also am on my period, so I'm not going to be too hard on myself. Your snow melted. In Oregon, they have over a foot. I think it's still snowing where Shelby's at. Hi, Renee. So I've been trying to force myself to drink more water because maybe that will help with my headache. But I've been suffering with this headache since Saturday. Ugh. So hopefully Rissa can help work it out because I told her I think I need to fix the tension that's in my shoulders and in my neck because I think that's what's contributing to my sore head. And then on Wednesday, I'm going to go see my friend Melvin, and she's going to cover up all of this. Look at all my white hair, you guys. Oh my gosh, there's so much of it. And so she's going to help me do some coloring on Wednesday. So I'm going to be in Eva Beach on Wednesday. Hi, Jayeen. We have 5 minutes left. So this morning before I went to the doctor, I was watching a movie, and it made me sad. It was a really old movie, though. Did you guys see, did anybody here that's here in Hawaii, did you guys see the Living 808 this morning, and they had the sharpening knife thing that we were on? Because I completely missed it because I was at the doctor's. And I really wanted to see that one because I can't remember what it was that I had said or learned. And I wanted to watch it again because it was this whole kitchen tips about how to sharpen your knife using, oh my gosh, what is that thing called, you guys? Not the sharpening stone, but the thing that, I can't think of what the word is now. Shelby loves the snow so far. So far. What is that called, you guys? The thing. It looks like a sword thing, like a stick. What is it? Oh, God, I can't think of what it's called. Not a sharpening stone, but a sharpening... that, whatever it's called. So he was showing us how he uses that because I have never been able to use it. Like, I don't know how to use it. I just use a sharpening stone, or I get, like, a knife sharpener that does the work and you just go like that. And so we got to learn from Sam how to sharpen your knives using that thing. What is that thing called for sharpen your knife? The one that's like a stick?
Steel.
Sharpening steel. I see Ramel knows what it's called. I don't know what it's called. Let me get my salt ready. I have garlic salt, I have kosher salt, and I have regular table salt. What should I use? Maybe I'll use a little garlic salt. How about that?
Mommy, can I try the chicken?
Sure. Let me get you a piece. Me too. I hope the numbers are good too. Here. Use your fingers and grab it. Let them know thumbs up or down. Bye, Joe. They can't see you. Up or down. Oh, there's a fly. Hold on. Hang on a second. It's on the outside of the screen. But I want to send a message to all his friends and family to not come inside the window. So I'm going to shoot him anyways. Funny thing is, it's usually I get the results from my labs like right away, and it's been a while, so I'm hoping everything's okay. We have 2 more minutes for the cabbage.
Okay.
Did you like it? Up or down? Yay, Emily likes it. So you're going to eat it with cabbage, or you're going to eat it with rice? Do you want to eat it with cabbage, or you want to eat it with rice? What's that? I don't know what that is. What is that? Cabbage or rice?
Is that rice?
That's cabbage. Oh. You want cabbage or rice? Because I'm going to reheat the... Okay, I'll get you rice. That's... So we're going to reheat rice. I'm just getting my salt and pepper ready. Sharpening rod. Rod or steel. So I'm, yeah, that's what I'm saying, Paulo. No news is good news, I'm hoping. Because when I did it last July, my cholesterol was a little bit high. Not like alarmingly high, but a little high. So we're hoping that it kind of went down. The concern was that my blood pressure was a little high, but a contributing factor to that could be my headache, that my head hurts, and so it was making my blood pressure a little higher. It wasn't like scary high, just like right above the threshold for him to say, okay, we have to check you again. So I have to go back in 2 weeks and do a blood pressure check. So hopefully you guys all were able to watch the whole episode of the Sam Choi thing. I wanted to edit it and cut out all the commercials, but I haven't had time to do that yet. I also haven't had time to answer my emails and stuff. So I have a bunch of orders that I'm going to be putting through. I also have fundraiser orders to put in. So if you guys are wanting to order anything from the fundraiser brochure, please message me by Friday, because I'm going to put that in on Friday. And I'm also going to be submitting orders for everybody else on Friday too, so I can put them all together. What else is there? The smart multi cooker. So that product that I used to make,
use this for your lips.
No, put that back. I don't know where you got that from.
Your makeup.
No, put it back. That belongs in my makeup kit. So that smart multi-cooker that I can make potato macaroni egg salad. You can also cook rice and cook pasta, steam fish. That thing is still free with everyone who joins by March 1st. So they extended that all the way through March 1. So you'll get the kit. You'll get the thermos, the small one, and you'll get the multi cooker, all for $99. Yes. Can I help you? No.
She just wants to be on TV.
Oh, she wants to be on TV.
She wants to be on film, or you want to be on Facebook.
Okay, go put her on Facebook then.
Say hi to everybody.
Say hi to everybody.
Okay.
Say hi.
Watch out! Hot, hot, hot. We just have to let it depressurize and then we're gonna open. Hi Shirley. Hi Terry. Hi Kelly. Are you still in Mexico? Or Mexico?
Mommy.
Kelly, the last time I saw her post, she was there. She's going gallivanting. Oh, let me warm up the rice. What?
This one over here.
Put my ears back because I need that for the trip. So we're leaving in March. So the same time we leave is the same time Shelby comes in from Florida, Oregon.
So she's coming
back. So she's going to show up when we're leaving.
She's going to come on next week, March.
Next week, March.
Jayden says, hi, Ramel, Christine, and Emily.
Hi.
Let's check. That has a little bit of pressure. We'll let it depressurize first before we try to open it. Because if I open it now, I'm cheating the cabbage from continuing to cook. We want it to be... We want it to be soft, but not overdone. But it won't be overdone.
Mom, can we put it on the side? Can we put it on the side?
No, everybody wants to... We want to wait and watch for that to go down.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody is watching for that to go down.
Why?
Let's try to test this thing out. Let's see. So everybody's waiting for this thing to drop, the pressure valve thing, and then once that goes down, we can safely open the pressure cooker. So Emily, would you like to say, why don't you talk to them? What do you want to say?
At school, when we were going to do PE,
yeah,
we were playing checkers, but it was a different game.
What was it? What is that?
Knock out.
What is knock out? You have to punch somebody?
No.
Oh.
Can we move this so we can show them?
No, they're looking at you. Look at your face right there. See?
So, we played it outside, right outside of our classroom.
Uh-huh.
So first we put our, you know those foam big ginormous puzzle pieces?
Uh-huh.
It were green. All of them were green.
Uh-huh.
So we put our base on top of that.
Okay.
On the ground. So we put the puzzle on the ground.
Uh-huh.
Then we placed the base. Then we have to choose who is going to be the red or the black.
Okay, what's the point of the game? You're supposed to knock somebody out?
No. So if you do this, this is fine. If you do it like this, if you do it straight and then you do this, it's going to be crooked.
I thought this was a puzzle game.
Then if it's not like that, then you have to go... You have to go like this.
Oh.
Then.
Okay.
Then, when you knock someone's red or black.
Puzzle or marble?
It's not a marble.
What is it?
It's a small kind. It's like checkers, but it's not like the same thing as checkers. So it's a small ball. It's a small circle that is flat. So first we have to set it up.
What is it called?
Knock out.
So we're just going to Google it because I don't know what game this is.
So we set up our dots.
Uh-huh.
Then... We jump in a pole, whoever goes first.
Uh-huh.
Then whoever beats the other one
yeah.
gets to go first.
Okay.
So if they do it like this and they knock someone's dot, they have to keep theirs.
Okay.
So if they knock out your dot, then they get to keep your out.
Okay.
Whoever gets...
It's not pogs. She said it's called knockout.
Whoever gets one more, and if the other kid has one more, and the other child has three more, or four.
Yeah.
If they knock it off of the board,
they win.
Whoever gets no more, the other child wins.
Oh, great. So you have to knock them off the board. So let me show them the cabbage. So here's the cabbage and the onions. This is 12 minutes.
Then can we put this on the side now?
No. So this was 12 minutes. So it's cooked perfectly, actually, after 12 minutes. And I cook this in the soup or the remaining sauce from the corned beef. And I'm just going to pour this on top. And then we're going to cover it so it stays warm.
So here we go. Half of it is on the board. That means you still get to play.
I have not salted or peppered this. But I think everybody can salt and pepper their own, especially after my doctor's appointment today. One moment, please. I have to watch my sodium according to the doctor because of my blood pressure and my headache. So I'm probably not going to put salt on mine, but if they want to, they can. So I'm doing this. I want to cover it because I want to keep the meat moist underneath. And so dinner is done. So I did 2 rounds, 30 minutes each of the corned beef. I could have probably done 30 minutes and 15. And then I did the cabbage afterwards. The sauce was the brine that the corned beef was packed in. And I added about a cup of water. Actually, I added a cup of water in the beginning. And then I flipped it and I did it for 30 more minutes. And then when I added the cabbage, I added a cup more of water. So you may need to add salt and pepper to it. I didn't because I'm trying to watch my salt intake. So that's why I did not do it. But I'm going to taste this. Romel said it tasted fine. But I'm going to taste the cabbage now and make sure that the cabbage has enough seasoning. Yes, it does. To me, it doesn't need salt or pepper. I think it's perfect the way it is. The only seasoning that I put in this thing was the packet that the corned beef came in. So this is done. Yes.
If the other half is on and the other half is off, that means you're still in the game.
Okay. So we're all done. Are you done talking about your game?
No.
You're not?
No.
We'll finish it up because we gotta go. Mommy wants to eat.
If somebody has one more and the other one has three or four or five and they knock it off, then they win. So then we change people, then we both challenge each other.
Okay, so that's how the game works. It is called...
So we get three partners. So my partners were Nicole and Sierra.
What's the name called again? Knockout.
Yes.
So we're going to Google knockout because now I want to know more about this game.
And
but we're going to log off now because I have to get this done and the dishes cleaned, Emily. So can you say bye? We can talk to them tomorrow.
Some days ago, my classmate Grayson, he came back.
So Grayson came back. Okay.
He came back from...
Oregon.
Another place.
I don't know where he went. He moved and he came back. Yeah. All right, so we're going to say goodbye.
Bye.
Bye, everybody. Can you say bye-bye? Can you say bye-bye?
Bye.
Bye. Can you blow a kiss? Mwah. Thank you.
Bye.